always low, low prices at Pahrump Valley Auto Plaza.
Well, the first thing you do is to prevent from getting the flu. Always prevention is the best thing. How do you prevent it? Get the flu shot. It's very simple. But some people don't want to get the flu shot. I have conversations on a daily basis about people getting immunizations. So first is to understand that if you want to prevent getting sick, you should try and get immunized. You should get immunized for this. Because once you get sick, we have very limited resources and very limited things we can do for you. So number one. Number two is that you should stay away from people who are sick, who are coughing. Three is you wash your hands and you have good hygiene. I tell people when they come to our doctor's office, by the doors we have hand sanitizers. Sanitize your hands when you're leaving, because just touching the door handles and some of the surfaces in the doctor's office is a really good place to get sick. So it's prevention is the first thing you do with the flu shot, with staying away from sick people. And if you do have the flu, the best thing to do is to make sure anybody who's coming in contact with you is doing the same thing, washing their hands and taking preventative actions. Just being in the same room doesn't mean that you're going to get it. However, if you get in contact with respiratory particles, sneezing, coughing, those particles can make you infected, and then it continues to spread. That's the way flu spreads. One person gets it, one person can get it, for instance, in Beijing or Hong Kong, come to the United States, and then all of it spreads throughout the United States, and it's passed from person to person. So good hygiene protection can really make a big difference for you getting ill. And, for instance, one person in family can get it, and doesn't mean that everybody else is going to get it. It just presents differently in groups of people. We don't understand why.
Can you get the flu from a flu shot?
You cannot get the flu from the flu shot. The flu shot says inactivated. And by the way, there's no mercury, there's no thimerosal. There is none in a flu shot unless it's a multi-dose, and we don't have those. So you're not going to get sick from the flu shot.
Why does the CDC look over at Hong Kong and stuff to determine what we're going to be getting here in the United States?
Fascinating question. It's a fascinating process they go trying to find what type of flu strain, what type of specific virus is coming from what parts of the world that seems to be able to be strongly symptomatic in humans. So, for instance, they're looking at livestock, they're looking at ducks and geese, and they get flus also. And if that is an outbreak in another country, and they send teams out to say, what is this? They identify what this is and say, is this going to be virulent? Is this going to be causing symptoms in humans? What's the chances? So it's a group of people that then meet and say, we think these are the most common ones that can come to the United States and causes. So it changes every year, and there's so much work that goes behind trying to figure out what type of strains that they need to manufacture. It takes a year to ramp up and to produce all this vaccine and then to distribute it in the United States. It's really an amazing process for people who are trying to protect the humans from getting the flu in that particular season.